Welcome dear students in today's practical session in which we perform an experiment related to chloride ion present in a provided water sample by Mohr's method. So basically Mohr's method, it is a method in which there is a precipitate formation or takes place in between silver nitrate and whatever the chloride ions are present in a provided water sample. In a provided water sample there is a presence of calcium or magnesium salt of chlorine, that is calcium chloride or magnesium chloride. So when such type of chloride salts are present in a water sample, it reacts with water and form hydrochloric acid, and that hydrochloric acid affects the metallic surface where the corrosion of the metallic surfaces are taken. Mostly water are used in a industry for a different purposes in a chemical reaction, and that hydrochloric acid causes corrosion of a metal, that is loss of metals are taken, and due to that the efficiency of that reaction chamber or boilers are decreasing. So to avoiding that, it is essential to find out whether there is a presence of chloride ions and also to remove that chloride ions from a water sample. The aim of today's experiment is to estimate the amount of chloride present in a given water sample by Mohr's method. So this is a precipitate type of titration. There is a titration are present where the precipitate formation are takes place. So apparatus, simple apparatus are required for performing that experiment, that is burette, pipette, conical flask, beaker. So such type of well-known apparatus which are easily handled by the student. So these apparatus are used during performing that experiment. Then after that, the chemicals are required. So chemicals, 0.01 normal silver nitrate solution, solid sodium carbonate solution, and a potassium bromate indicator, and a provided water sample. Such type of chemicals are used during performing that experiment. Then next, the procedure. Important part is the procedure. So step first, in that step, we fill the burette by using silver nitrate solution. In second step, we take a 10 ml of the provided water sample. In that 10 ml water sample, we add a pinch of sodium carbonate, then shake that complete solution, that is the dissolution of sodium carbonate are takes place in the provided water sample. After that, we add a few drops of potassium bromate indicator. After addition of that potassium bromate indicator, the solution have a yellow color. Then next, that complete solution is titrated with a silver nitrate solution, which is present in a burette. During addition of silver nitrate solution, the red color is appeared. This red color is disappeared. Then continue the titration till a permanent brisk red color is obtained. Permanent brisk red, that is reddish particles are formed in a conical flask. So that is our end point. We call it as yellow to brisk red color is the end point of our titration. So in that manner, we perform three different titration and taking three different reading. By using that reading, we obtain a constant burette reading, we call it as CBR. And by using that CBR, we calculate the chloride ion contents present in a provided water sample. So this is the observation. In burette, we fill 0.01 normal silver nitrate solution. In conical flask, we take 10 ml of provided water sample and pinch of sodium carbonate. Indicator is used, it is potassium bromate indicator, and end point, it is yellow to brisk red. So this is the observation. After that, whatever the readings are obtained, so these readings are entered observation table where initial burette reading are present, final burette reading, and we are taking the difference between final and initial burette reading. So three readings are taken during performing that experiment, and by using that three reading, we obtain CBR, constant burette reading, or mean burette reading. And by using that CBR or MBR, we calculate the chloride ion content present in a water sample. Let us perform the experiment. I demonstrate an experiment by using simple way. Please observe the video in which I perform an experiment related to chloride ion content present in a water sample by a simple manner.
Now Today I am starting our first experiment, that is to determine the amount of chloride content present in a provided water sample. And for that purpose, chemicals are required, that is 0.01 normal silver nitrate solution. Then small proportion of sodium carbonate, that is anhydrous sodium carbonate, and indicator is required, which gives the end point of that experiment, that is potassium chromate. So these are the three chemicals are required in a present experiment, along with a water sample in which chloride contents are present. So first of all, we wash all the apparatus, that is burette, this is conical flask, this is pipette. So these are the basic apparatus are required during this experiment. So now I start an experiment. So first of all, fill the burette by using silver nitrate solution. I am taking a clearly washed burette, and this burette is filled with a silver nitrate solution. So freshly prepared silver nitrate solution are taken for the experiment. This is a type of precipitation titration, where a precipitate formation are takes place in. Carefully fill the burette and also adjust the zero level. So this is the zero level is adjusted in burette. Also complete removal of air bubble. Then next, we pipette out a 10 ml of provided water sample. Specially in that experiment, a tap water is provided. Tap water, that is a unknown water sample, and from that tap water we pipette out 10 ml water. So in this way, we pipette out 10 ml water sample by using a pipette. So in that water sample, 10 ml water sample are taken in conical flask. Then add pinch of sodium carbonate. Pinch of sodium carbonate and few drops of potassium chromate indicator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And shake this complete solution. And titrate with silver nitrate solution. A drop wise addition. Our end point is yellow to brisk red color. Some particles are observed. It is a type of precipitation titration. The precipitate get formed in that experiment. A continuous shaking is required during titration, because a complete mixing of silver nitrate water sample are essential. So in that way, at the bottom, there is some reddish particles are absurd. And now this is our end point. The reading is 8.7. This is our first reading. Now again repeat same titration. This is first reading. We are trying to second reading. Then next third reading. Because we consider a constant Bure rate reading CBR or MBR mean Bure rate reading. So Bure rate is filled for a second titration. Zero level is adjusted. We pipette out sample 10 ml water sample. 10 ml water sample is pipetted in a conical flask. Then add a pinch of sodium carbonate and indicator. Nearly 3 to 4 drops of indicator is sufficient for titration. Then shake this complete solution for a complete mixing and titrate it with silver nitrate solution. So first reading is 8.7. So in that part, that is second reading, it is 8.2. Now this is third part. Again fill the burette. By using silver nitrate solution and pipette out 10 ml of water sample in a conical flask. Pipette out just a 10 ml of water sample in a conical flask. Then add a pinch of sodium carbonate. After addition of that pinch of sodium carbonate, we shake that water sample plus sodium carbonate. And then add a few drops of potassium chromate indicator. After adding that indicator, again shake the solution. And this is third reading. So shake the titrate this solution against silver nitrate solution. Our end point is yellow to brisk red color, not complete red color, but in yellow color some particles are observed at the end of titration having brisk red color. So precipitate formation are started, and in that precipitate there is some particles having brisk red color are formed, which is nothing but our end point. So if we observed in that solution some red colored particles are formed and the reading is 8.2, so our third reading also 8.2. in this way we perform three titrations, and after that we obtain constant Bure rate reading, that is CBR, and by using that CBR we calculate the chloride content present in a water sample.